Yeah, back live here at Firestone Fieldhouse. Pepperdine winning the first possession, the opening tip, but not able to convert on their first trip down. Hope everyone's having a great holiday season. Boise State, the opponent today. They'll get the ball in just a moment for being mopped up. Broncos and the Waves, final non-conference game of the year. The Waves will have 12 days to get ready for Pacific on December the 30th, while Boise State plays Colorado State in their Mountain West opener on the 28th. Next time out. Both teams coming off very tight road losses, competitive games. On the floor for the Waves, Malia Bambrick, Cheyenne Givens in the backcourt, along with Allie Sedman. Three-point freshman threat for the Waves. And then up front, Jayla Rufus-Miller and Becky Obima. For Boise State, Mary Kay Narrow, Anna Ostley in the backcourt, along with Dominique Leonidas. Up front, Elodie Lalotte and Abby Muse are the forward. Same starting five, all 10 games now for Boise State. Ball poked away by Jayla, and right away the Waves force a turnover, and Boise State will take it right back. Each team with an early turnover here in the first 40 seconds. Leonidas getting baseline cut off by Obima. Left angle shot, that is no good, missed by Lalotte. And Pepperdine will have another trip down the floor. Givens, dangerous pass, and it is nearly taken away by the Trail Bronco there, Abby Muse. Fortunately for the Waves, last touch Boise State. Waves will get it back. Malia Bambrick will inbound. This is the fifth meeting between the Waves and the Broncos. 2-2 all time. Nobody in this series has ever won a road game. Before the inbounds pass, Abby Muse will pick up the first foul of the game. 2 years ago, these two teams met up in Boise. Tight game, 76-74, won by the Broncos. Malia Bambrick played in that game, and a Pepperdine foul here. Again, before the inbounds pass, this one's going on Givens. Each team with one foul, not yet a minute in. And this fifth renewal between these two teams. The only Mountain West team the Waves see this year. Meanwhile, Boise State already lost to a West Coast Conference team. Got beat badly by BYU. Broncos out on the far wing. In front of the Pepperdine bench. Muse up top. Hand it right off to Narrow. Narrow goes to a right, defended by Bambrick. Player-to-player defense right now by the Waves. Ball dumped in, last touch by Obima. Muse had the inside position on Obima, but it will be a shot clock violation, as it turned out, on Boise State. Still looking for our first points of this one, a minute and a half into it. First of a doubleheader for you here on the WCC Network. The Pepperdine men will take on Southeast Missouri at 5 o'clock tonight. Cheyenne Givens, she'll be fouled on the way to the lane. And that'll be on Anna Ostley. Ostley, the sophomore guard out of Scottsdale, she is the three-point threat for Boise State. 17 for 49 on the year. As you see the foul there, already a couple of fouls for the Broncos. 140 into it. Cheyenne Givens has it. And she'll launch a three, not connect. Obima, offensive rebound, strong side. Couple of bounces, Bambrick puts it up. Floater no good, off the rim a couple times. Loose ball and a held ball underneath. Jayla tied up with Muse, and the held ball will favor Boise State. Bronco basketball. Broncos 1-2 in true road games this year. Waves are 2-2 here at Firestone. And there's another Bronco turnover. They wanted Ostley in the corner and overshot her. Pepperdine basketball still looking for our first points. Can't remember the last time we went this deep into the first quarter. Not that we're all that deep, but we're still 2-10 into it. And neither team has scored. Collectively 0-3 from the floor. And collectively six turnovers in this game already, three for each side. Cheyenne Givens, right side Stedman. Crossover, Stedman launched a deep three. No, short, offensive rebound. Jayla, reverse, layup, no, but she is hit hard to the floor. And a couple of free throws coming up, 7:30 first quarter. Let's take a look as Lalotte picks up the foul. Nice hard work by Jayla, and this is what she brings to the floor. Not necessarily a prolific scorer, but she does bring a heck of a lot of hard work to the floor, especially underneath the basket. Also runs down the balls, the 50-50 balls, very nicely. So free throws coming up for Jayla. Waves are a 70% free throw shooting team. Jayla misses the first. Now 7 for 13 at the line this year. Pepperdine Women's Basketball, I'd like to extend its thanks to Nike, the official outfitter of the team. And on the internet, the home of the Waves can be found at pepperdinewaves.com. News, schedule, scores, stats, and more can all be found on the official athletic website. Well, we're still scoreless as Jayla goes 0 for 2 at the line. Bronco basketball, the Waves applying a lot of pressure. And after 9 seconds, the Broncos finally clear. Far side, Osley for three, no. Weak side rebound, Malia Bambrick, push it ahead to Allie Stedman. Both teams very much out of sync offensively to start this game. Floater no good by Bambrick. Obima comes up with it, and yet another held ball. This one will go to Pepperdine on the alternating possession. So 3 minutes in, still looking for our first points. Two teams have started out collectively nothing for six shooting and a total of six turnovers. Givens with it. Givens with seven to shoot. Givens goes to her right. Givens a runner mid post, put it up, and it drops in. So it takes 3 minutes and 15 seconds. Finally, somebody on the board this afternoon. Cheyenne Givens, Osley down the floor in the key, defended by Obima. She'll have to pull it back out. That's Mary Kay Narrow, the 5'11 sophomore from Beaverton, Oregon. Go across the way. Stedman, some tough defense, denying the baseline. Looking for the entry to Muse. It's poked away from behind. Turnover, and the Waves take it back. Givens driving baseline. Knocked away. Recovers. Double team. Obima in the middle of the key. Put it up. It's way too strong. The ball volleyballs way out there to Bambrick. Stedman, versus to the corner. Givens, 360 over Osley. Off the window and in. Cheyenne Givens with all four. And with 5:55 to go first quarter, it's 4-0. Ball in the key and a wide open lot. Misses underneath. And Stedman will take it away. That's as uncontested as it gets. And Broncos are still held off the scoreboard. Stedman, a 360 move, in and out down low. Obima's second effort, that's no good. Boy, you talk about a struggle in the first half of the first quarter offensively. And this time the Broncos are on the board driving to the hoop. It'll be Leonidas to finally get Boise State going. 4-2 Waves. Pepperdine basketball. Givens with all four for Pep so far. Jayla driving left side of the lane, whistle underneath, no. I believe the foul will be on the floor. Abby Muse will pick up the foul. That's her second. Four already on the Broncos, and it looks like they actually called it on a shot. All right, so Jayla will go back to the free throw line where she missed the pair a moment ago. Amelia Mosa on the floor for the Waves. 6'1 freshman out of Garden Grove. Miali had a nice game recently on the road. Free throw good, 5-2. Mosa, the freshman with the modern day high school. Hails from Garden Grove, the same hometown as number 23 for Boise State, Lalotte. Their star player who went to Orangewood Academy, won a CIF title there. Three-point shot is in there for Caitlin Burgess off the bench. Burgess, a junior out of Auckland, New Zealand, transferred in from College of Southern Idaho, and we're tied at five. Kendall Carson on the floor, left side Stedman, no good. Weak side rebound, Amosa. Give the Waves a second chance here. Kendall Carson goes to her left. Also on the floor for the Broncos is Trista Hull, 6'2 freshman forward out of Yakima, Washington. Crossover to the hole, Bambrick underneath, no good, and we're going the other way. Bambrick is 0 for 3 from the floor, and it's Boise State basketball when we return. 5-5 first quarter, on Wavecast and the WCC Network. Five-five, 4:18, first quarter. Jane Wabba is on the floor for the Waves. Bronco basketball finally getting it into the front court out of the timeout. Nobody other than Cheyenne Gibbons with a basket yet for Pepperdine. 2-for-9 shooting. The Broncos 2-for-5. Leonidas up top. It goes to Trista Hull down low. Off balance, no, but a foul on the Waves. And that is going on Maylee Amosa. First on her and two on the Waves as a team. So Trista Hull going to the free throw line. The Broncos having trouble in the early goings this year at the free throw line. And that's one example right there. That one way off the mark. Trista Hull 15-for-29 on the season at the line. And make sure you follow Waves Hoops on Twitter, Pepperdine WBB on Instagram, and Pepperdine Women's Basketball on Facebook for all the latest news and information on the team. Hull splits the two. The Broncos lead it 6-5. This is Stedman, freshman, gets baseline, dangerous pass intended for Carson in the corner, but broken away by Osley. It'll stay with the Waves. Jayla Rufus-Milner, Allie Stedman, Kendall Carson, Miali Amosa, and Jane Wabba for Pepperdine. Wabba looking inbound and near the corner. It goes to Stedman. Wabba one bounds. Jayla off her fingertips. Going to track it down barely, but it goes right in the Hull's body, and Boise State will take it away. Each team now with four turnovers, 6.5 minutes into it. Broncos have their first lead. Far wing, Leonidas get it to Osley. Deep three, she can hit those. That one a little too strong. Long rebound out to Stedman. Push it ahead to Kendall Carson. And the Alaskan gets it to Amosa. And it right back off to Kendall Carson. Kendall didn't play at Portland State. Another tight loss for the Waves. Most of their losses have been inside single digits. That one missed underneath. In fact, all but one of their losses really decided by a couple of late possessions. The games the Waves have won this year have really not been in question, all three of them. 6-5 Broncos in the slow scoring first quarter with 2:49 to go. Left side three from the near wing. That's off the front of the rim, missed by Mary Kay Narrow. Pepperdine basketball, Jane Wabba front court. Slash into the key. A foul is going to be called from behind, I believe, on Trista Hull.
Fouls against Boise State on number 22, Trista Hull.
This is good ball work by the Waves, pushing the ball down the floor, and nicely done by Wabba, slashing to the lane and creating some free throws. May note, top of the broadcast, the Waves have to get the ball to Jane and Becky a little bit better inside and give themselves some opportunities at the line. We like the fact already that the Waves will have taken at least six free throws in this quarter, only making two of them, but doing a little bit better job already getting to the line. And this 6-6 tie and the backcourt pressure. Pepperdine will get the ball back on the court for the Waves. Eve Brasilis, 6'1 redshirt junior forward out of Newton, Victoria, Australia, by way of Utah Valley. Brasilis, the number three leading scorer on the Waves at 9.5 a game. Stedman straight away. No. Bronco rebound. Dominique Leonidas in the front court for the Boise State Broncos out of the Mountain West Conference. Four straight conference championships from 2017 to 2020. Five NCAA appearances in the last 7 years. Solid program. Three-pointer no good. Leonidas, middle of the key rebound. We'll reset the shot clock to 20, and we're going to go under 2 minutes in just a 6-6 ball game. Down low and over two Waves. Scoring will be Trista Hull. It is 8-6 Boise State. Waba, right side Stedman. Waves, nothing for their last four. No baskets now, approaching 4.5 minutes. And a foul will be called on the Broncos. That was actually Rachel Bowers on the other end of the floor who made that underneath and picked up the foul here. So Moso go to the line. Bowers is one of three Californians on the Bronco roster. She's from Newhall, went to Canyon High. 6'3 senior. Fairly young Bronco team, though. Only four players on this roster, not within their first 2 years of being in the program. Amosa for the tie. Got it. So 8-8.
Becky Obima returning.
And Becky Obima's back on the floor. Amosa will sit. And more pressure put on by Pep in the backcourt. Making the Broncos work to get it into the front court, and they do with a few seconds to spare. Up top, Hull goes to the left side for Caitlin Burgess. Down low, kick out Leonidas for three. That is off the back of the iron, no. And underneath, I think that was Carson who hit it last. Yeah, Carson thought the Bronco hit it last. She just let it go. She had inside position on her. But clearly, Carson hit it last underneath. And that is blocked by Obima, the shot blocker on the year for the Waves. That's her ninth of the season. Crossover underneath by Brasless, misses, and at that, draws an offensive foul. Wow. Well, double whammy there. That was a nice play on the other end for the Waves on a beautiful block shot. Ninth of the year for Obima. Set up a nice transition, but Brasless missing and then picking up the offensive foul. Under a minute, 8-8. Leonidas from 13 straight away. Boise State back on top, 10-8. The ball pushed to Jane Wobb in the front court. Kick out the corner, Bambrick. Bambrick, couple of bounces, dribbles out of the corner. Carson turns her head and gets some directions from Coach Kristen Dowling. By the way, Dowling again joins us at halftime today. Obima, handed off. Carson runner, no good. Too strong off the window. And if they want to, Boise State can play for one shot. They lead it 10-8. Up top, Trista Hull. She hands it back off to Mary Kay Nero. With 10 to go, shot clock off. Leonidas dribbles out of the corner. Lob it with the court to Burgess. Burgess with four. Burgess with two, and from 14, that's no good. Just inside free throw line extended. Burgess misses in what turned out to be an extremely low scoring first quarter. Boise State 10, Pepperdine 8 after 10 minutes from Malibu on Wavecast on the WCC Network. First shot down the floor, missed by Boise State to start the second quarter. Bambrick the other way, put it up, no. Jane Waba inside position on the rebound, but last touch. It'll go back to the Broncos. The Waves really having a tough time offensively in the first one quarter plus. 2 for 13 from the floor. That's 15.4%. 0 for 3 from 3. Nobody other than Cheyenne Gibbons has made a basket. Boise State ball, they're 4 for 15 shooting, not much better. They have a 2-point lead from the corner. Burgess from three, no good. Lalotte, offensive rebound, one of the toughest rebounders in the Mountain West. Waba makes a nice play, though, in front of her. Let's take a look what happened here. Three was missed, offensive rebound Lalotte. Obima stays with her, and last touch, in fact, her left foot was on the end line there. So Bronco basketball, Nero, front of the Wave bench, looking for the little give and go, but not on the same page with Lalotte, and the Broncos turn it over. Six turnovers for Boise State, five for Pepperdine. rebounding, plus two for Boise State, 14-12. Jane Waba, front court, waves have to get some flow going offensively. A couple of bounces for Braslis. Put it up middle of the key, count it and go, and that's one person you can certainly look to, Eve Braslis. All the flashy feet in the world. Take a look here. Defended by Leonidas. Great feet and in the air. Leaning towards her left, throws it in over her in the middle of the key. And the three-point play is complete. And the Waves are back on top, 11-10. Yeah, Braslis averaging 9.4 a game, five rebounds. Another hard worker, especially from that kind of range. Mid-range game is terrific for the Utah Valley transfer. Tough defense there. Narrow one-on-two, has it blocked again by Obima. Carson was there as well. Allie Stedman crossover, runner no good off the window. Braslis offensive rebound and a tie-up. It'll stay on that end with the Waves. Boy, through it all, I'll tell you, and the Waves have a lead with 8:26 to go in the second quarter, in spite of 3-for-15 from the floor. And the five turnovers. That's... By the way, what hard work will do for you, and the Waves, absolutely one of the hardest working teams there is. Driving, underneath, roll, no good. But a foul will be called, and Kendall Carson will be shooting two free throws. That one's on Osley. Two on Osley, two on the Broncos. Lux Bus America is the exclusive bus transportation partner of Pepperdine Athletics. That's Lux Bus America, covering more ground in more places. Kendall Carson, free throws, first is good. That makes her 5-for-6 at the line this year. Doesn't get there much, but again, the Waves, historically a really good free throw shooting team, just need to work on getting there more, particularly as we approach WCC play, which starts in 12 days. That's the next game on December 30th. It'll be a day game, Pacific rolling in. Mary Kay Nero, get it to Lodi Lalonde. Drive into the hole, up with it, no, but fouled. And the Boise State's leading scorer, Lodi Lalonde, will go to the foul line. Obima picks up her first. And it's been a major struggle for Lalonde at the line this year, 8-for-23. Make it 8-for-24, 33%. She is their only double-digit scorer on the season at 10.7 a game and had a really nice outing with the 16 points at Washington State. By the way, Washington State just suffered its second loss of the year today. Lost at BYU 71-53. Handful of other West Coast Conference teams are in action, either head up with our starting time or a little bit later. Texas State at LMU, Arizona State at San Diego, Pacific at UNLV, Cal Baptist at Santa Clara on tap. Allie Stedman, get it to Kendall Carson. Lob it out to Braslis across the way. Stedman throws it nice and high off the window and gets it to go. 15-11 Pepperdine, first lead of four since 4-0. Lalonde miss it on the right angle. Bambrick comes up with it. Bambrick crossover, Bambrick going all the way, no good on the runner inside the block. Obima offensive rebound, back out to Bambrick. Reset on the offensive rebound. Stedman for three, got it. Stedman's been a much better three-point shooter on the road than at home in her young career, but she nails that one. And the Waves have their biggest lead of the game, 18-11, as Boise State calls a timeout, 7:03 to go before halftime on the WCC Network. Well, that was Stedman's 12th career three-pointer in her initial season at Pepperdine, but just her second here at Firestone Fieldhouse. And it puts the Waves up by a game-high 7, 18-11, 6:45 to go second quarter. Lalonde one-on-two in trouble, kicks it out again. Nearly taken away by Braslis, going up with it. will be Lalotte. On the court for Boise State, number two, Lindsay Lovrovich, 5'9 freshman guard out of Gig Harbor, Washington. As Boise State's in his zone, Becky Obima off the block, couple of bounces, fake right, turn left, trying to get over Lalotte, going to be fouled. And that's exactly what has to be done if you're Pepperdine. Got to get her more touches, take advantage, get to the foul line. And at that, you also put another foul on their leading scorer, Lalotte. Right, that's her second. Three for Boise State in the quarter, which means they just have one to give. And Leonidas back on the floor for Boise State. And Obima's first foul shot will go in. First point for Becky Obima. She's been out there 10 minutes. Does have five rebounds. Pepperdine plus two on the glass, 16-14. Starting to find a little bit of something on this end of the floor as well, offensively. What was initially just two for their 15. Waves now have connected three straight times. Waves 19-13, Boise State back the other way. Drop it into the lot, one on two. Trapped there on that right angle. A lot in some serious trouble. Get it to the corner, Leonidas, and she is going to be bumped, and Obima doesn't agree. There was nobody, nowhere to go for Leonidas. A little tough luck there for Becky Obima, who will leave the game. Boy, somehow, Leonidas able to draw the foul. Waves by six on defense. Leonidas, a couple of bounces in front of the free throw line, handed off underneath, and that will go for Sydney McQuieter, 6'2 sophomore forward out of Keller, Texas. Pepperdine basketball. McQuieter only averages about 4 points per game. Bambrick underneath, her first basket in six tries. Waves again by six. Narrow driving to the hole, whistle, that's an offensive foul. Player control foul as Amosa hits the floor. So Narrow picks up her first, but that's four on the Broncos. Good call, Amosa had position there outside that circle. Waves by six and the ball, biggest lead a couple of minutes ago at 18-11. Can reestablish that game high lead with a basket here. Stedman, a no-look pass that almost cost her, deflected into Bambrick's hands. Under 5 minutes to go before halftime. Bambrick driving. Bambrick going to have her shot blocked. And up ahead it goes to Leonidas. Three on three of the way. Leonidas from 13. Straight away she hits. Nice play on the other end on the block by McQuieter. And it's 21-17. The Broncos are now three for the last three. Cheyenne Gibbons, who had the first two baskets today for Pepperdine, gets it to Stedman. In fact, the only two baskets for Pepperdine in the first quarter. Stedman, a little bit careless with the ball, deflected off of Bronco, and they'll stay with Pepperdine. 4 seconds to shoot. Waves are 6 for 20 from the floor, 30%. Broncos 7 of 22, 32%. And prior to the inbounds pass, a foul will be called. And that'll be on Trista Hull, her second. And that means 5 on Boise State, and that means free throws for Pepperdine.
Shooting 2 for the Waves.
Gibbons shoots two, the first one rolls around the rim, no good. Second foul shot, and that hops in there after three bounces on the rim, 22-17. Leonidas, he's hit a couple from there. That's no good. Rebound, Bambrick up ahead to Givens. Givens puts on the brakes around that mid post. It goes to Brazlis. Whip it left to Malia Bambrick. Defended by Mary Canero. Bambrick goes to her right. Bambrick. And too much for Amosa. Waves. That's actually the first turnover of the second quarter. So pretty good there, but six for the game. Broncos with it, and this is something that's worked very nicely for the Waves, the backcourt pressure, but McQuieter is by herself. Somebody forgot about her. 22-19. McQuieter is a Boston College transfer. Givens, Brazlis, top of the key, driving to her left, trying to get around Hull. Amosa, that's good. Straight away, that's about 17 feet out. And Amosa's in the scoring total, 24-19. Amosa had a free throw earlier. Ball poked away, gets it done on the other end. Goes in the hands of Stedman, waves by five in the ball, under 3 minutes to go before halftime. Freshman from Monterey Day has it, get it to Brazlis. Steve Brazlis, long downtown shot and buries it. Wow. Eve Brazlis is so effective anywhere on the floor. She nails a deep three, and this is the biggest lead for either side. 27-19. Leonidas in a little bit of trouble, gets out of it and gets it to Hull. Mary Canero goes to her left. Look it around left side, Leonidas. Dump it in to McQuieter. Defended by Brazlis inside the block. Put it up short. Amosa comes up with a rebound. This has been a very nice first half for the freshman. Amosa, three-pointer, Bambrick. No good, short. Amosa, rebound, up with it. No. Hits the floor hard. Great effort, though. Back the other way, 2-on-2. And a nice dish from Leonidas to Osley. 27-21, getting closer to the half with 1:40 to go. Waves still by a half dozen. And driving left side of the lane, Cheyenne Givens. Givens with seven to lead the Waves here in the first half. Both teams have picked it up nicely offensively in the second quarter. Remember, it was just 10-8 after 10 minutes today. Osley to the right angle. To Hull, defended by Amosa, and nearly turned it over. Osley with it, nine to shoot. Osley trying to get baseline, cut off by Amosa, down low, dangerous pass with four. Ball kicked out to nobody in particular other than Cheyenne Givens. 2-on-1, Stedman from Givens. Cheyenne Givens, a nice assist, her first, and Stedman with the deuce. She's got seven. Waves have a double-digit lead, under a minute. McQuieter in the key, put it up a little too strong, and Bambra comes up with it. With 37 seconds to go, about an 11-second difference, game clock, shot clock, and now is a great time to settle things down. Might be the last time you see the ball in the first half. That's exactly what Givens is doing. Going to burn some clock and try to get a nice shot. Amosa behind the free throw line with seven to shoot. Now you got to go five. Stedman straight away three. Had really good look. It didn't go. Rebound. Leonidas back the other way. Waves with numbers, though, with six. Narrow kick it out. Osley a deep three. That is short. Givens rebound. Up ahead, Bambrick. That will not count. And that is it through 20 minutes of play. Very well done by the Pepperdine Waves, who lead Boise State 31-21. We'll talk with Kristen Dowling in just a moment. Waves by 10 at halftime in this non-conference finale on the WCC Network. Halftime here at Firestone Fieldhouse, and absolutely one of the better quarters of the year for Pepperdine. 23-11 in that 10-minute frame. And there's the halftime score. Game-high lead for the Waves, 31-21. Waves did a fantastic job all the way through. Allie Stebbin right now, right there, the leading scorer on Pep with 7 points, one of nine Waves to score in the first half. 30-3 there, that gave the Waves at the time the biggest lead of seven. Finally got some offense going at that point. And down low, Trista Hull was one of their key players off the bench for Boise State. Bambrick, a nice runner through the lane. Malia Bambrick, that was her only basket though, in eight tries. Some nice minutes from Sydney McQuieter off the bench for Boise State. Dominic Leonidas finding a wide open Anna Osley underneath. That was Osley's only basket. Stedman the other way. And the Waves on top, 31-21 at halftime against Boise State for the Mountain West. Third quarter coming up. Waves by 10 on Wavecast on the WCC Network. Look, some halftime numbers. Pepperdine 37% from the floor to Boise State's 32%. Broncos have hit just one three-pointer in eight tries. Pepperdine 2-for-7. Waves plus three on the glass. Broncos plus two on assists. But the Broncos have also turned it over three more times than the Waves. Pepperdine did a much better job in the second quarter taking care of the ball. Just one turnover there in that 10-minute stanza. Waves had a really nice second quarter, 23-11. After just 8 points in the first quarter, Waves by 10. We've already told you BYU, a winner today over Washington State, 71-53. The Cougars are 9-1. Halftime from Jenny Craig Pavilion, Arizona State 41, San Diego 33. Torero's off to a nice 7-2 start. Kristen Dowling, third-year head coach for Pepperdine. Let's see if the Waves can put it all together in the second half. There's Gordy Presnell, who has really built a Mountain West Conference dynasty in the Boise State Broncos. Six NCAA tournament appearances, five of them in the last 7 years. Bronco basketball to start the third. Good ball work all the way around. And an assist by Lalotte as she finds a wide-open Abby Muse, 31-23. Abby Muse becomes the eighth Bronco to score. Remember, nine Waves scored in the first half. Very balanced. Obima off the block, a couple of bounces over Lalotte and gets it to go after a couple of bounces on the rim. And the Waves are back up by 10. Mary Kay Nero, 3-on-2, a little bit out of control, hits the floor hard and tripped up just inside the circle. Becky Obima will pick up her third. Might be a little trouble there. First foul for either side in the second half as Nero will shoot some free throws. University Credit Union invites Pepperdine students, alumni, and staff and faculty to open a university checking account. You can earn up to 5% annual percentage yield on your university checking account for the banking you already do. Visit ucu.org to join today. Federally insured by NCUA. Terms and conditions apply. Nero's first foul shot is good. 5'11 sophomore out of Beaverton, Oregon. That is her first point, believe it or not, of the day. Number three scorer on Boise State this year with 8.4 a game. 33-24 as she splits the two free throws. Broncos 3-for-6 at the line today. The Waves shot 15 free throws in the first half. That is a fantastic number, even though they've just made nine of them, but that's what you want. Amosa, good feet there, holds that back pivot and throws it in. About a 7-footer. Amosa had some very productive minutes in the first half. She's got six, along with four rebounds. It'll give and go through the lane, and Nero's got her first basket. 35-26 with Cheyenne Givens in the front court. Givens with seven. Jayla Rufus-Milner, who made a start today, gets it right side to Stedman, who had the halftime high for the Waves, and that's in and out of the hands of Jayla on the pass. Nothing wrong with the pass. Jayla's got to keep her eye on the ball, and didn't there. 35-26. And just the second turnover for the Waves since the first quarter. Bronco basketball inside the free throw line. Leonidas. Back out it goes to Osley. Osley's 0 for 3 from 3, their leading three-point threat on the year. And a little give and go to Nero, and a Pepperdine foul. Jayla picks up the foul. First on Jayla, two on the Waves. And Mary Kay Nero at the line and misses her first as the Broncos continue to struggle at the line. This year coming in to 60% at the line, and today they're not at 50%. 35-27. Front court, Cheyenne Givens. Mimosa sets a pick. Givens looking to go to her right, puts on the brakes, finds Jayla up top. Couple of bounces on the dribble, poked away by Nero briefly. Back into the hands of Malia Bambrick. Bambrick, a little shake and bake, looking for a possible backdoor, doesn't get it. Instead, behind her to Givens. Seven to shoot for Cheyenne. Long triple, bury it. Wow. Cheyenne Givens several feet behind the three-point line. And the Waves are up double digits, biggest lead of 11. Ball poked away by Jayla, and a foul will be called. And boy, that's... I'd like to see that again. Right near the half-court line. Let's see. Well, here's the long three. A heck of a shot by Cheyenne Givens, who is having a wonderful game. She's in double figures now. And then the ensuing call against Jayla. A couple of fouls for her now. Down low, Lalotte puts it home off the window. Just two baskets, though, on the day for Elodie Lalotte. 5 points. One of the top rebounders in the Mountain West Conference, held to just one rebound in the first half. Stedman down the left side of the lane. Jayla up with it. No good. Doesn't get it to go off the window. A rebound underneath. Broncos on the move. Leonidas 2-on-3. Osley up with it. No. Givens might have gotten a piece of that, and a held ball after the miss. And we'll take it the other way on the possession arrow. We'll go to the Waves, who lead it by 9, 6:40, third quarter. Waves are 42% from the floor today. Broncos 37.5%. Just a fantastic second quarter for Pepperdine, but the start of this third quarter, kind of similar to that of the first, really struggling to get an offensive flow in the early goings. Offensive foul here, and already four fouls on Pepperdine. Not yet 4 minutes into the quarter. Eve Braslis back on the floor. Pressure put on in the backcourt. Leonidas clears the 10-second timeline. Waves by 9, back on defense. Led it by 10 at half. Backing in, Lalotte. Leonidas back out to her. It's 8 to shoot, and a foul from behind. Another foul on the Waves. That'll be on Bambrick, and Boise State will be going to the free throw line for the rest of the third quarter. 6:03 to go, and the Waves are over the limit. Pepperdine doing a fine job keeping Boise State off the free throw line in the first half, where they just took four foul shots. But this is the fifth and sixth already of the quarter for the Broncos. Leonidas with 7. A lot of Boise State fans in attendance. Of course, they have several who hail from California. Leonidas splits the two, 38-30 under 6 minutes third quarter. Amosa up top. Braslis, lob it out to the left for Cheyenne Givens, working on Osley. Dribble between the legs. Givens through the key, off balance, and good. Awesome game for Cheyenne Givens. She's got 12. And it's 40-30. Got the halftime lead back of 10 points. You're going to have to play, I would think, somewhat conservatively on defense if you're Pepperdine. They're over the limit. And too close of a game for Boise State to chip away at the line. Runner no good by Muse, and an offensive foul at that. So the Waves will get it back, and Lalotte just picked up her third. That is the first foul for Boise State in the quarter. And jogging it right down the middle of the court will be Cheyenne Gibbons. Gibbons is 5 for 6 from the floor. She's got 12 points, 2 assists, a steal and a rebound, and a foul at the baseline. That'll be on Abby Muse. And that'll be 3 on her. So both her and Lott with 3. Inbounds, it goes up high to Amosa. Center it to Cheyenne Gibbons. Through the key underneath Bambrick. No good on their underhand roll, and a rebound to Muse. Outlet, Mary Kay Nero runs it up for the Broncos. Left side, down low a lot, turns, little hook of 3, miss it. And Amosa comes up with it. A chippy for Lalotte, their star player. And for the most part, it's been a frustrating afternoon. Sitting with 5 points and 3 fouls. And a little bit too much for Amosa there on the turnover from Stedman. That'll bring us to a stoppage in the action in the third quarter, 4:37 to go, Waves by 10 on the WCC Network. ...40-30, Pepperdine, 4.5 to go, third quarter. Waves had a big second quarter of 23-11. That's certainly been the difference so far. Boise State basketball to our right. Most a tough perimeter defense. Up top, Leonidas. Get it in the key to Hull. Hull defended very toughly, but a nice move there to the basket for Mary Kay Nero, who's got the deuce. Nice looking, too. Tough defense. Waves couldn't do much more on that end. And Waba down low, looking for Stedman in the corner, and too much for her. Go back to the Broncos. 8-point ball game here in the third quarter. Osley. To Hull, one bounce dribble back to Osley behind the 3-point line. Hull will set a pick. Lob it to Leonidas. She'll launch a 3 far wing. Wow, that's as far down as it can go, and it did not go. Waves come up with it. Kendall Carson back on the floor. Carson's been out there 9 minutes today. Just a couple of free throws for her. Stedman. Give and go down the middle. Caught awkwardly was Amosa. She had to get rid of it. Gets it back from Braslis. 6 to shoot. Jane Waba. Waba leaning in from 15. Almost got it to go. And it trickles all the way out to Osley. Handed off to Leonidas. Waves by 8. Back on defense. Underneath. Ball missed by Hull. Gets her own ball back. Leonidas. Crossover. Leonidas through the lane and beats everybody. 6-point ball game. Leonidas with 9. That's a Boise State high. Stedman driving. Runner does not hit anything inside the lane. Broncos come up with it. Mary Kay Nero. Nero's had a nice third quarter. Kick it out near wing. Osley back to Nero. Nero with 6. And blocked by Waba underneath. Nice block shot by Waba. Kendall Carson will settle. Near wing, it goes to Stedman up front. Player to player D right now for the Boise State Broncos. Left side 3, Kendall Carson buries it. Carson's first basket today on 2 tries. The Waves are 4 for 9 from distance. Holding the Broncos just 1 for 9 from 3. And the Waves are up by 9 and take it away on the other end. Chance to go up by double digits again. A floater no good by Braslis, but Omosa comes up with it. Carson, other way, Stedman for 3. No, off the back of the iron, and Braslis. Third try coming up for Pepperdine. Carson will reset. Allie Stedman crossover, pull up, 14 feet out, it's too short. Hull with the rebound, and Osley will now run it up down the middle of the court. Hand it off to Mary Kay Nero. 80 seconds to go in the third frame. And a foul away from the ball.
Fouls against Pepperdine on number 13.
Now remember, though, the Waves were over the limit with 6:03 to go in the third quarter. There's 1:19 to go now.
And
I think the Waves have done a nice job, you know, avoiding the fouls in that stretch. So about a five-minute stretch now, the Waves have been over the limit, and Boise State hasn't taken any free throws since. They have six free throws in the quarter, but all of that was leading up to the fifth foul. So very nice job defensively for Pepperdine without fouling. Broncos today are 5-for-10 at the line. Make it 5-for-11. Pepperdine has not taken a foul shot in the third quarter after 9-for-15 in the first half. And the two free throws by Rachel Bowers are split. Waves by 8 and the ball with 1:19 to go in the third. Reminder, this is a doubleheader for you. Men's game at 5 p.m., Pepperdine men against Southeast Missouri. The Waves will have a nice little break, 12 days before the West Coast Conference opener in this building, a 2 o'clock Thursday afternoon game to start conference play against Pacific on December 30th. Waves will get it back across the way in front of the Pepperdine bench. Approaching a minute to go in the third, Kendall Carson. And a nice little lob down low for Waba, or excuse me, for Becky Obima, and counted in one there. Becky Obima will have a three-point opportunity. Dominique Leonidas will pick up the foul. Initially, that first pass, though, it was a little bit too much for Obima, and she got her own ball back and threw it in, so it worked out. Three-point play possibility, and that is going to go in, so the Waves are up by 11, had a 10-point lead at half, under a minute to go in the third, and Becky Obima able to complete the three after the nice look-in by Carson. Narrow up top, Leonidas thought about the three, get it to Lalotte, and she is going to travel with it. Lalotte is continuing to have a rough day as Boise State's leading scorer on the year. In fact, their only double-digit score. It's been held to 5 points and just one rebound. A lot's been out there. 16 minutes. Look in for Obima with 26 seconds to go and turn it over. Shot clock now gone. Mary Canero the other way. Broncos look to play for one shot. The Waves might have a double-digit lead going into the fourth quarter. Pending this possession, Mary Kay, get it right side to Burgess. Up top, Lalotte, swing it on the reversal with four. Leaning in, 17-footer, Leonidas hits it as the third quarter comes to an end. So the Waves still lead it by 9 after three quarters as Leonidas goes into double-digit scoring. And the final 10 minutes coming up of the non-conference schedule on the WCC Network. Boise State basketball to start the fourth, and a great look at as they work it deep into the shot clock and laying it in, Abby Muse, 46-39. The Broncos have actually won two of the three quarters today. They won the third quarter 16-15. They won the first quarter by two. It was the second quarter that's keeping the Waves going here. The Waves had a 23-11 second frame, lead it by seven now with Malia Bambrick out to the right. Handed off to Stedman, seven to shoot. Looking for a long-distance triple. It is short. Obima, for a moment, had the offensive rebound, but then knocked out by Lalotte. It'll stay with the Waves. Obima not yet up. Little by little, rising up, and it appears to be okay. Reset the shot clock to 20. The Waves looking to wrap up the non-conference schedule on a high note. Lead it by seven, looking to get to 4-5. The 12-day layoff coming up. Boise State will get Colorado State to open up the Mountain West in 10 days. Cheyenne Givens with a season-high 12, make it a season-high 14. Cheyenne Givens, 14 points, 6 of 7 from the floor. The lot's going to be double-teamed. Great help defense by Obima. Jayla was on her. Obima came over. Shut her down there. The lot's been held to 5 points. At the block and underneath. The lot over Obima is going to get that one. So the lot with 7. And the Waves are up by 7 with 8.5 to go in regulation. Looking to go over 500 at home this year is Pepperdine. Trying to defeat a team that's been to the NCAA tournament 5 times in the last 7 years. Jayla going to have a block, gets her own ball back. Malia Bambrick has it now with 6 to shoot. Does she know the clock? 4 to shoot. Malia straight away, she knows the clock, fires one from distance, does not hit anything. It is out, officially a shot clock violation. And Boise State will get the ball back. Broncos a chance to pull to within 4 or 5 here. The Waves have had several times this year already a tough go at it in the fourth quarter. Looking to close it out this time. And there's a tripping foul. Last time we were here, Cheyenne Givens picks up her second foul. Last time we were here 3 weeks ago today against Cal State Fullerton, it was that fourth quarter. That was the undoing. A game that we felt that the Waves had full control over on the heels of a fantastic win against UAB. Just didn't finish the game out against the Titans. We'll see if they could do it this time. Shot blocked by Nero. Got her own ball back. Running floater no good by Burgess. And the Waves come up with it. 48-41. 2.5 gone in the quarter. Cheyenne Givens. Best game of the year for her to date. Get it to Jayla Rufus-Milner, who made a start today. Milner with 4 rebounds. Down low, Obima, no, but fouled. Back to the line.
Fouls against Boise State on number 11, Caitlin Burgess.
Caitlin Burgess working it in to Obima nicely today. We thought that was a key to the game. The Waves are getting closer to WCC play. It's going to be very important to get it into the big interior threat of Becky Obima. First foul shot is short. 10 for 17 today are the Waves at the line. And just 1 for 2 in the second half. Second one gets a friendly roll, 49-41. The Waves go back on defense. Waves have been fantastic today on defense. Boise State just 1 3-pointer, being held under 40% from the floor, and there is a beautiful block by Obima. Last touch by Boise State, and Leonidas is down. Incredible defense by Obima as Leonidas goes into the padding there pretty hard. Being attended to now by the trainer. .703 left. Gordy Presnell, their head coach, is out there. See if he can take another look. But Obima has just been incredible today, especially on that end. Ticket Smarter, smart play of the game. And here it is. Cheyenne Givens on a beautiful assist to Allie Stedman on a fast break. Givens has had a monster day. And Allie Stedman, who had the halftime high for Pepperdine of 7. It's now Givens, who has the team high of 14 today. Beautiful connection. That's the Ticket Smarter play of the game. Smart play of the game brought to you by Ticket Smarter, the best place to find tickets to the hottest sports, concerts, and live events near you. Visit TicketSmarter.com or download the app to secure your tickets now. So, Leonardo's gets up for Boise State, which was nice to see after the hard block by Obima. She'll be out of the game, Leonidas will. Jayla Rufus-Milner, one bounce to the hole, laid up and in. Getting a lot to the basket, and the Waves are back up double digits, 51-41, had a lead of 10 at half. Narrow runner, no good. Stedman's got a grab that. She tipped it, and the block by Gibbons against someone who's several inches taller than her. Obima, a fight for it with Muse, and a hell ball situation. Wow, what a shot, what a play by Cheyenne Gibbons. Let's take a look at this. Gibbons blocking the shot of Muse. Muse is 6'3". Gibbons is 5'7". That is 8-inch difference right there. And Gibbons got the block shot. And Pepperdine today has 6 block shots. 4 of them by Obima. Gibbons gets her first. Waves by 10 and the ball. 6:17 to go. Kendall Carson, get it to Obima behind the free throw line. Why not shoot it? It was straight, just a little long. The lock comes up with it. I like the shot, though. You might as well. She had a pretty good look. Back on defense, where the Waves have been playing extremely well. Maybe the best defensive effort of the year. Got the 6 block shots, keeping them by and large off the free throw line. And Boise State with just 1 three-pointer today. Osley out to the left for Burgess with 6. Burgess, and knocked away by Malia Bambrick in the key. Wow, that's 5 straight empty trips for Boise State, and they have not scored now in over 3 minutes. Bambrick gets the steal on that end, and Carson on this end. Dribbling up and down, burning some clock with a 10-point lead. Almost half of the fourth quarter gone. Lob it to Obima at the midpost with 4. Goes all the way across the key and on the run throws it in. Wow, Becky Obima. Obima with 9. Along with 6 rebounds, 4 block shots. Nice day for her as the Waves are up a dozen. Osley up top, Lalotte swing it to the right for Narrow with 8 to shoot. Narrow knocked away briefly from behind, left side Osley for 3, that's going to be in there. That's just the second three-pointer today for Boise State. Burgess with 1 and Osley, who came in with 17 on the year to lead their team. That's her first 3 today in 4 tries. So she's been held in check with 5 points. Waves by 9, 4:20 on the clock. Allie Stedman. The freshman from Arizona having a fantastic day. To the hole, underneath, didn't finish. Osley comes up with it. A little bit of everything though from Stedman today. 7 points, 3 rebounds, 2 assists, a steal. Osley behind the arc. And stolen by Stedman, her second steal. This should be her 9th point. Stedman with 9, 55-44. Timeout, Boise State. With 3:43 to go, and just a matter of finishing now for Pepperdine on the WCC Network. Waves by 11 with 3:40 to go in the game. Back on defense and applying more pressure. Front court Burgess, wide open 3, going to get that one. Her second 3, and a quick one out of the timeout, makes it 55-47. Kendall Carson in the front court. Now it's really a question of taking care of the basketball and might have to hit some free throws down the stretch here in the final 3:17. Carson posting up Jayla, instead go to Stedman. Stedman for a long 3, that's no good. Ball tipped and into the hands of Osley, who will run it up. Broncos are going to probably look to go quick with each possession. Can't afford to waste too many here in the final 3 minutes. Right baseline goes to Muse. Kick it right back out to Burgess. High post, Muse backing it on Carson. Whistle and a foul will be called from behind. 2:49 to play. Jayla Rufus-Milner will pick up her third and two on Pepperdine in the quarter. And we're going to take a break. Waves by eight on the WCC Network. 55-47, Pepperdine looking to close this one out in the final 2:49. What a day it's been for Cheyenne Givens. For the Waves, 14 points, 6 of 7 from the floor, her season high today, as the first free throw is missed by the Broncos, and they have struggled there, just 6 for 12 at the line. And News makes that one 55-48. Waves' biggest lead was 12 about 2.5 minutes ago. That's down to 7. Givens. Defended by Osley out in the perimeter. A little curl pattern for Stedman. One bounce, crossover. Stedman, hook good underneath to Obima below the layup. Boise State comes up with it. Stedman looking for the steal. And a foul will be called on Stedman trying to do so. So that's 3 on Stedman and 3 on the Waves. So the Broncos can make things even more interesting here. We got plenty of time, 2:20. Looking to get it down to a 2-possession game right now. Burgess, get it to Osley. Muse, defended by Rufus-Milner. Help defense there by Stedman, trapped there and taken away by Jayla. 2-on-2, Jayla down the middle. Jayla up with it, no, but fouled. So 2 free throws for Jayla Rufus-Milner as we go under 2 minutes. Nice steal on the other end. Again, the trap defense has been a monster today for Pepperdine. Boise State hasn't really had anything good to come of it. And Jayla hits the first of 2. She's got 4, 2 of 5 at the line. Waves are 12 for 19, 12 for 20 now today at the free throw line. But it's nice to see 20 free throw attempts. 1:50 to go. Waves by 8. Burgess, too much off the window. Rebound news. Jayla again, very active. Kick it out, Osley for 3, bury it. So that tightens things even more. 56-51. You're going to have 90 seconds to go. I would suggest being productive on this trip down if you're Pepperdine. Cheyenne Givens, Becky Obima. Back to Jayla. Swing it left to Cheyenne. Having her best game of the year. That's not a great pass. A lot was right there. Luckily, it was not stolen. Just tipped it out of bounds. It'll go back to the Waves. 10 seconds to shoot. Waves are without a basket, nearing 3 minutes. Givens. Givens driving up with it. No, but fouled. Well, good job there. Create some free throws at least. And that's Osley picking up the foul. Nothing else. Get to the free throw line. 21st and 22nd free throws of the day coming up. Cheyenne Givens already her season best performance of 14. And that one is grazes the front of the rim and misses pretty badly. And the Waves go under 60% today at the line. There you see her all around numbers. 6 of 7 from the floor. Givens uncharacteristically misses 2, but takes away the ball from Osley, who had position on her to grab it. It was deflected a couple times. You can burn some clock here. Now, offensive foul. See, again, you know, you have an opportunity with just over a minute to go to burn some clock. Instead, quickly picking up an offensive foul. All you had to do was pull it back out. Up by 5, you could have taken the clock down to, what, 40 or 45 seconds at least with a 2-possession lead. But this gives Boise State some extra time here. They could pull it within 1 possession. Burgess, Osley, long 3, yep. She got hot at the wrong time for Pepperdine, and now a timeout. This is a 2-point ball game. The Waves were up by 12. 4 minutes ago. 56 to 54. We'll leave it here with 48 seconds to go. Their biggest three-point threat, Osley, who was shut down in the first half, all of a sudden has three threes, all in the quarter. She's got 11 in the game. And Becky Obima has had a huge day. 9 points, four block shots. That was one of them. Terrific feet across the lane. Got it to go off the roll there. And another block shot from Obima. She stepped on the end line on that particular play. But wow, this would be, if the Waves do not finish this game, it would be an awful loss to end the non-conference season. Had a 53-41 lead just over 5 minutes to go against a team that's been to the NCAA tournament five times in the last 7 years and the Mountain West champions four times in the last 5 years. Yes, the Broncos have struggled with a 3-6 record this year, but if you're Pepperdine, you absolutely have to close this thing out up by 12 halfway through the fourth. Becky Obima, there you have her numbers. 9, 6, and 4. But again, I go back to that last rebound, you know, that Givens had to really work hard for. Boise State had two looks at it. Givens had the rebound, a chance to reset the shot clock and burn another 20 off the clock. You'd have what, about maybe, you'd have inside of 30 seconds to go in this game with the ball. And Boise would be in a position where they'd have to foul. Now they don't. Ball advance into the front court as we're under a minute. Bambrick can't get the ball in. Now you got to call another timeout. So that'll leave the Waves with one left. Broncos with two timeouts left. A reminder, Pepperdine men and Southeast Missouri at 5 o'clock on the WCC network. The Waves going to go into break, 12-day break, and hopefully it's a nice 12-day break. We finish this game off. Cheyenne Givens, just a huge day with her 14 points. Terrific court leadership. Nails a three there. 6 of 7 from the floor. A couple of rebounds, couple of assists, a steal, and a block shot, by the way, for Cheyenne Givens today. Against a player that was 8 inches taller. But this game has gotten way too interesting in the second half of the fourth quarter. Givens. And now they're going to work clock, but again, if the Broncos get a stop, they're going to have a look to tie it or win it. See what happens here. Givens with the ball. Comes to her left. Nero with some tough defense. 8 to shoot, 25 game clock. Givens driving. Givens pulls it back out with 4. Givens, a little bit of trouble, and throws it away. The Broncos stepping right in front behind the high post. It'll be Boise State basketball. And the Broncos will take a timeout, set it up in the front court, and would you believe, a chance to win the game right now. We'll leave it here. A 2 could force overtime. A 3 would win it, and the Broncos have been shooting the 3 here in the fourth quarter. Leonidas here, great drop off for Osley. And Osley got hot in the fourth quarter. The Broncos have connected 4 of their last 5 trips. The Waves have gone the last 3-34 without a basket. But that hasn't been the biggest problem, to be honest with you. Broncos in the front court, shot clock is gone. 16 seconds to go, 2 to tie, 3 to win for Boise State. Mary Kay Narrow up top, defended by Givens with 8. Behind her it goes to Osley. Osley defended by Stedman at the three-point line. 2 seconds, Burgess, a long 3 off balance, is going to go over the backboard. Time expires, they might add, let's see if they add some time. The Waves should win the game with that miss. They might add some time. Let's see what happens. That's it, no time added. I thought they might have added a second or a little less. But somehow or another, the Waves hang on. Didn't play all that well in the final 5 minutes, but had a big enough lead to win it, 56-54. Coming back to wrap it up on the WCC Network. Well, the Waves' defensive effort today was fantastic, and it needed just one more stop at the end to win it, and the Waves got it. Avoided a fourth quarter meltdown today as Pepperdine scores just 3 points in the final, 5:19 of this one to win at 56-54. Becky Obima was huge today with 9 points, 6 rebounds, and 4 block shots. And a season-high performance from Cheyenne Givens with 14, exactly a quarter of the Waves' points, 6 or 7 from the floor. Elodie was held in check, came in as their leading scorer, scored there, but Elodie finishes with just 7 points on the day. A couple of baskets under her season average. Amosa had a great first half. There's a nice little give and go as Boise State started to make its move halfway through the fourth after Pepperdine had a game-high lead at 53-41. Jane Waba right there, one of 6 block shots today for Pepperdine. Waves here with a 9-point lead. Boise State underneath, Muse getting in on the action. And Cheyenne Givens, absolutely the player of the game, taking it to the hole. Givens in a starting role today with a season-high 14 points. Getting a lot of production, Pepperdine did, from all over the courts. I believe 10 players scored today, yeah, for Pepperdine. And the Waves will go into the break at 4-5. Boise State goes to 3-7. A reminder, 12 days from now, WCC play against Pacifica. Stedman gets the steal and goes all the way to the other end. Pacific will be here on December the 30th. There's your final. Pepperdine gets one final stop at the end to defeat Boise State 56-54. Thank you to Game On Entertainment. Happy holidays to you. I'm Darren Preston. Final score, Pepperdine 56, Boise State 54. This has been Pepperdine Basketball on Wavecast and the WCC Network. Happy holidays, everybody.